As a Home Assistant user, you will often face challenges when accessing and editing configuration files. While the system offers many options via its user interface, there are times when modifying YAML files directly is required to make changes in your system. This can be challenging for anyone who doesn't understand YAML and how to format it correctly. While there are several methods in Home Assistant to make changes to your configuration files, the File Editor add-on is the simplest browse-based solution that is very easy to set up. Once you get comfortable with the YAML syntax, I recommend it as the fastest and most explicit approach. It will force you to recognize and understand the syntax when making changes and occasional mistakes. But before we start editing, let's dive into the YAML basics so you can understand the format and how to define your configuration. Home Assistant uses YAML as its main configuration language. It's designed to be human-friendly and quite easy to be picked up by beginners. The basic building blocks of YAML are key-value pairs. You specify the key, colon, and the value. So here we have created two attributes, name and age, which is the key in this case, and after colon, we specify the value. YAML uses indentation to denote structure. Child elements are created under their parent elements. YAML uses spaces at the start of the lines to show when something belongs to the element above. So in this example, we have created the family parent element and the guardian child element with a value of mum, and we have used two spaces to present this relationship. You can also combine key value pairs and lists to create more complex objects. We need to use hyphen to create a list. Each item in the list starts with a space and a hyphen. If you take a look at our family parent object, we have added another child element of children, which consists of two elements in the list. Lists aren't limited to just string values. They can hold numbers, nulls, booleans, or even more complex objects. Here we have added a child element of pets that holds multiple attributes, a type and a name. In the event when the list element is more complex and has several attributes like this one, the hyphen will always indicate the start of the element in that list. Spaces at the beginning of lines show how everything is related. If you look at our family object, the parent, children and pets, they all belong to a family. Everything below children is a child and everything below pets is an information about a pet. This structure allows you to organize information in a way that shows relationships between different pieces of data. The YAMllint.com is a helpful online tool for working with YAML files. It checks if your YAML code is valid and properly formatted, and this can be super useful, especially at the beginning if you're just writing YAML and want to make sure that you haven't made any mistakes. So at this point, you should be a bit more familiar on how to write and format your YAML config files. So the next step is to install the file editor in the Home Assistant. In order to do that, we need to go to the settings, add-ons, add-on store, click the file editor and install. Once it has installed, you want to add it to a sidebar and then click start. Once the application has started, we can open the web UI, and here in the editor, we can edit our YAML configuration files. And just to show you the YAMllint website that can validate config, all you have to do is copy and paste your config, hit go, and it will tell you that the config is in correct format. If there is an error in your configuration, it will tell you the exact line. That way, as your config grows and you keep adding to it, you can keep verifying and making sure there are no mistakes in your configuration. Back to the main file editor, I just want to talk about the best practices when it comes to creating YAML config files. In general, it's a good practice to split your configuration and make them easier to maintain. Instead of one large file, you want to create separate files for different components and then use exclamation mark include to inject them into the main file. This keeps things clean, avoids duplication and simplifies debugging, and it also prevents an individual config file to grow too big as you keep adding settings and components to your smart home system. You also want to use consistent indentation with 2 or 4 spaces per level. Definitely you want to avoid tabs as they can cause errors. And group related items together. Use comments to explain complex sections for future reference. You can add comment starting with a hashtag and it will usually be in green color. And then use the quotes around strings containing special characters or spaces. For sensitive information like password or API keys, you want to keep those in a separate secret YAML file, as this keeps private data and out of the main configuration. YAML supports different data types. Those include text, numbers, boolean values, and nulls. Strings don't usually require quotes, but you can use them for clarity or when a string contains a special character, like space. Once you have finished editing your YAML config file, you can hit save, and you can also verify your config in the Yamllint website just to make sure that it's valid if you're still in the learning phase. I really hope you found value in this video. If you did, why not give it a big thumbs up? This will help to grow my channel. Also, if you're new here, you could subscribe. That way you will be notified every time I release brand new video.